Alright, in this video I'm going to do some examples involving taking derivatives using the good old chain rule, or as it's sometimes called, at least this is how I first thought about it, was being the outside-inside rule. So this is what the chain rule basically says. It says you start off with a function that's actually a composition of functions, and it says to take the derivative of that, what you do is it's the derivative of f, the inside's left alone, multiplied by the derivative of the inside. So in terms of this outside-inside rule, notice you basically get the derivative of the outside function, evaluated at the inside function, and then you multiply that by the derivative of the inside function. And that's the basic idea with the chain rule. And of all the derivative formulas that you'll run across, probably the one that you'll use most often is definitely going to be the chain rule. So it's one of these derivative rules. It's a little confusing at first, but you definitely want to make sure that you get a handle on it. So let's do an example here. So suppose we have the function y equals, let's say, sine of x squared, and we want to take the derivative of this. Well, the outside function in this case is the sine function, and the derivative of sine is cosine. If it was sine of x, we would get cosine of x, but instead of sine of x, we have sine of x squared, so the derivative is going to be cosine of x squared, and this is where we have to multiply it by the derivative of the inside part, so we'll multiply this by our 2x. So notice we've got, if you think about again, the sine as being the outside, the x squared as being the inside. Notice we took the derivative of the outside part, we evaluated it at the inside part, and then we multiplied that by the derivative of the inside part. Okay, so that's a basic chain rule example. Let's do some other ones here. Suppose I have the function, let's say, y equals x squared plus 3x plus 4. Suppose we had it evaluated at the third power. Well, if you had to, you could always just multiply this out, x cubed plus 3x plus 4. Three times, combine your like terms, and then kind of use your basic formulas. But suppose instead of to the third power, I made it to the 30th power. Probably not going to want to multiply this thing out 30 times and collect your like terms. You can now think about the outside function as being the stuff raised to the 30th power. It even kind of looks like it's the most outside. So if on the inside we just had x to the 30th, the 30 would come out front. So the same thing happens here. The 30 will come out front. I'll leave the inside part alone. I'll take 1 away and get to the 29th power. And then again, I'll multiply this by the derivative of the inside stuff. The derivative of x squared is 2x. The derivative of 3x is just 3. And there's your derivative. Okay? So, I'm going to do some more examples of the chain rule on another video, some more complicated ones. I also have some more complicated chain rule problems on my website at justmathtutoring.com, but I'm also going to post some more shortly here on YouTube, but I just wanted to do a couple quick basic examples to get you going.